All right, guys, here we go. This was steps 14 to 25, and that includes building the tie rods. We did the rear shock tower. We got into some A-arms. 17 is some hub carriers. Some more tie rods here. Put in the front sway bar, rear hub carriers, more tie rods here, dog bones going in. That's the rear sway bar. And then the final two steps were pretty simple. That was the battery holder and then the radio plate. All right. And then there's one thing to note, and that's coming up right here. Step 23, there's a mistake in the manual. You see that OT241? That's the wrong size screw, it's too big. It's the screw that helps put the oh my God, what's that called? The connect the sway bar to the shock tower. So OT241, wrong one. You gotta do the smaller screw, and that is 1-532606H. So check out the first couple of pages of the manual. Figure out what screw that is. You'll probably have that in your parts tray. But this is definitely something you need to know about. A arms. Front and back. That's a nice shot there. Okay. Tie rods again. Back sway bar, you can see that installed. Hub carriers are in. All the way around. And then, of course, battery holder and then the radio plate. C clamp.